Second City worshipers worship like that, man. Worship till your belly empty. Amen. Worship till you give God all that you have inside of you. Amen. Everybody? Everybody? Brother George? Hallelujah. Where you was? Come, brother. Come. I can't see. I pass everyone. How many take you out? You know them? Them cap where they're supposed to be light in it? They must put on one and bring them in the church. I take you out. Everybody, God is good. Yeah, we give God what is due unto Him, man. We give God what is due unto Him. When we come, we give Him His praises. You know, we gotta sing the regular songs, I didn't know that. But hear what? We really want to tell God from our heart, and we bring it into a song to worship Him. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 So good morning again, everybody. We come together to praise God this morning, amen. And one thing we always say, I never know which direction God is going to lead us. But until you get in the Spirit, He will lead us, He will take us in His direction, amen. He will take us in His direction. So, I just want to, you know, I want to call Rena this morning. Rena, come. Hallelujah. Rena is very dear to my heart. Amen. Are we very glad? She dragging her blood coming. I want to know what. You like the curry load or no? That's true. You don't like the curry load? Amen. What is in the Spirit right now for the church?
Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody. I know that God have a lot of great things in store for Word in Action Ministry. And I know that everybody always go through something, but I know that God will bring you out. Right now, God is taking Word in Action Ministry on a higher level with new things, new anointing. We look at this here this morning and it was so amazing, but God have more in store for us.
And the more might be what?
More anointing, more blessing. God have more people to come into Word in Action Ministry, and God is just going to open new doors for each and everyone.
More people are going to get help.
Yes, and deliverance.
More people are going to get help, and they're going to get deliverance and all that. Because there are many people, I will be sure, Rena, I'll be sure. Take a mic. Praise the Lord. Wow. Yeah. I'm sure this morning there's people, Ronald, adjust that for me, please, thank you. I am sure this morning there are people just like you going to church this morning, and they go to church and they sit up with all their problems. And they went to church last week and the week before and the month before, with all their problems. And they have been praying honestly, But as you know, our time is not God's time, and God's time is not our time. Right? And they are looking to see some headway, some breakthrough. You know, something happen. In other words, they are looking to see something happen in their life. Because, you know, if it's me or you or anybody, and we go somewhere, we just repeat ourselves all the time, and then it's like nothing not happening. You may feel like you're going wrong around about, or you may feel as though you're spinning top in mud, you know, as he's saying, go. But what I'm saying this morning is that when people go, they want to see things start happening in their life. But when things start happening in their life, what they have to do to maintain that spiritual level, to maintain their spiritual relationship with God, what they have to do? Tell me what they have to do. Tell the church what they have to do.
They have to keep themselves in a place where they are always connected with God and where they always put God first. Yes, we have a lot of things to do in life, but we always must put God first and keep a connection with the Lord.
Because if you keep yourself connected with anything else, it might do you much good. Now, nobody don't say we don't have other things to do. The Bible says if a man don't work, he don't eat. Right? You have work. But you have to keep relationship. You have to keep relationship with God. Amen? Because as you know and I know, there are plenty of people in other relationship more than God. They make other things, they get in relationship with other things more than God. And it's true. How often do you pray? If I may ask you your business.
I pray, as soon as my eye open, I pray. As soon as I can even...
What time your eyes open about? I don't know, I'm just asking.
Anytime. Yes. Prophet, I always pray. Sometimes when I wake up in the morning, I pray. As soon as before I do anything, I pray. Sometimes my students be like, "Mommy, I'm hungry." I say, "Yes, I'll come in 1 minute." And he know that you have that respect for when I pray. Once he hear I pray, don't call. And Prophet, I just pray.
That's a good teaching to give the church as well. Yeah.
True. I just pray. Prophet, any time that I not doing anything, I pray.
Now, I want to tell you something, right? Rin, I know you're a young girl, but you're already married, so you're not on that, right? Let's say you was making man your God. And every minute, instead of running to pray, you're running to man. You're running to, well, you can't run to woman, right? But you're running to man. And let's say, a man, if he was making woman his God. So, from the time he get another spare chance, he run into woman. Alright? There's where his development will be. Is it true? But when you run to God, there's where your growth will be. Your growth will be in Christ. Because when you continue running to God, you know, it's like anything you get attached to, it's there is where you will feed from. Is it true? So, you is attached to God?
Yes.
Is attached to God? Because I know in the past, and I know probably still happen in the present, young boys, young girls will say, "I'm going to pray. No, I'm going to study. I am going to study." And they're studying, and you know when you're studying, you have to really think, right? I'm talking about studying for big exam. But the phone right in. They're studying and the phone right in. The boyfriend called. Bam, they take up the phone. You're not studying, but you can talk or no? You can talk. Once it's you can talk. And they start talking. And they're talking, and then after, they put on my phone and they go back studying again. Now, what am I saying? While you're studying, while you're praying, or before you pray, or when you want to pray, anything that come to distract you or to break your concentration, it is the devil. Is it true? Yes or no?
Yes, it's true.
You never find, we went to home to pray this week at home. While we was praying, the phone started ringing one day. So the woman said, nah, that's the devil. She said, from the time I started to pray, she said, prophet, you realize before we started praying, the phone ringing? She said, that phone on the ring right here. And I said in my mind, he's an intelligent woman. And then she turned around and said, don't worry now, I'll call her, I need that enough. So that I will not miss the call. And that is wisdom, is it true? But anything, let me tell you, anything in life that break your focus, your concentration, how would you describe that?
Well, anything that break my focus from God.
When I say anything, anybody do it.
Anybody, anything that break my focus with God.
How would you describe?
I would describe it as...
Not the work of the devil trying to distract you, sidetrack anyone.
I will say that because every time you're trying to reach for something from God, the devil has always come to steal it away from you. And is always trying to bring something that will occupy your time so you will not receive what God has in store for you.
True. So I believe God is warning people about if you are connected to Him, stay connected. God is warning people, if you are connected to God, stay connected to God. Because God time, you know, at one time I remember this. There was a person, they said, well, I have to go to work. But after I done work and time for church, if I have to do anything extra, I could use that time. But the work time, they will not use the work time because they know they will get fired. Is it true? So they will play around with God time. They will say, well, here, what? I was supposed to really go and worship God and praise God tonight, but I wouldn't go because, and you know it's good tomorrow, and you know it's good Friday, right? So they say it's okay to take God time and mess around with it. Play around with God time. What do you think about that? What do you think about that treatment that we human beings give to God?
I don't think that is a good thing to do because prophet, like you always say, what if when we're ready for God time and God say no, right now I am doing something else, or then something could happen to you in that space. And
what about if you catch a pain and when you catch a pain, you would not like God to say, well, this is not my time. You will have to remain without pain the whole night. Tomorrow is my time. You would like that?
No, I wouldn't
like
that.
So why we as human beings try to do God that?
Because we're too ungrateful at times.
Ni makaram is your word. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Every now, big clap. Come on. Hallelujah. The Makaram is the word. And according to Mr. Jack Warner, ni. Makaram. Amen. So, we are not called to be ni Makaram. We are called to be children of the Most High God. Because God time is any time and our time. It's when we feel like. Amen. So I want to thank God so much for the beautiful morning. I would like to call up the worshipers this morning as we dance in worship this morning. Amen. Rina, come. Take the cameras here for me, please. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Don't stand in front of the camera. Rina, stay behind. Maybe stand in front of the camera. We ain't see nothing for sure. All our YouTube and website, nothing. Everything crashed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, yes, let's just revise some songs. Steve Lloyd, Steve, you will get it. Praise the Lord. So good morning again, everybody. We are in the house of God. We came here for one purpose, and it's to worship God. Amen? One purpose and one purpose. This is not a social gathering. It's not a political meeting, everybody. So if you see some people in yellow, you see some people in white and some in green, don't think they belong to a party. They belong to Jesus, right? So Celeste, you belong to Jesus, right? So, different people, whatever color you see they come with, it's not a political party, right? Sister Devian, she in yellow. Did I look like black and thing? Nah, I safe. I safe. Who again? Are there any cops here? And the arena, man, don't see me right there. That's why you can't wear clothes in a wrong election. Every color is a party. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Give yourself away, man. So flesh will be operated. Don't let flesh operate.
Can you use me? I give myself away.
Don't sleep on my side.
I give myself away. So you can use.
Adrian, come. Come on, Adrian, come.
I give myself away.
Come, even
so love them.
Stand in the
center. I give myself away.
Yeah.
What would happen? It's a generation.
Worship God.
So here I am.
Woo.
Here I stand, Lord, my life is in your hand.
Yeah, man.
Lord,
that's the way we worship him. That's the way we worship him.
I give myself. Thank you.
next one?
Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. God is so great. This morning, I want to share something. Steve, what is the best thing you like when Dr. Vijay was here and we had to go all over the country with a maxi and we had to go and dance all over when he was here?
For me, the best thing was knowing that, you know, it's East Indian gospel and we could go there and promote East Indian gospel because, you know, a lot of people think when they come into Christianity and, you know, everything is about English. But, you know, when we went out there and we project the Indian culture, it goes to show that we could worship Jesus in whatever culture because it doesn't matter what language you speak. But once they give God all the honor and all the praise, and, you know, a lot of people were so amazed to see East Indian gospel and especially the dancers here dancing to the gospel because it was something that they have never seen before. And it was
when we went like places like DB, where all the Indians is, yeah. And I know people come from Central and was dancing.
Yeah, you know, when we went on to DB, you know, DB Pinal, where all the doubles and the sisters and about that plenty, you know. They were also so surprised to see, you know, people dancing to East Indian gospel because it was something that they're not accustomed to. And even though they're from down that side, it was something that they were not accustomed to. And it was such a blessing, but to me, I'm not sure what the rest of them, but to inspire, you know, others and, you know, project Christ through the different cultures. Because it's not about just one race or one culture, but Christ came for all people. So we incorporate everything. That's why you see us, we do East Indian, African, name it, we do it.
Praise the Lord. And that is one way to show. You don't tell people about love, you show people your love. Amen? Anybody could say I love you, no, but time to show the love by dancing in East Indian gospel. That is showing that, you know, Jesus loved East Indian as well. Amen? To say with the African.
What is the best thing you like about while we was there with Dr. Vijay? What he taught us and what we learned?
Yeah, when we went, you know, his wife was there, Dr. Vijay Bendik. He's from India and he's a Indian gospel singer. And when he saw Trinidadians come and he saw that we practiced his songs and we were dancing, he was amazed. I know it blessed his heart so much and he loved Word in Action so much, you know. He taught us, he gave us some pointer tips, you know, when we dance, you know. Look at the crowd and smile, keep upright all the time, you know. These are things, you know, we get from him, we learn from him, and he was so blessed to see Word in Action come and minister in that. Because he was amazed to know, you know, he way up in India, and he don't know we dancing his songs down here. I know when we went out there and, you know, it didn't just touch the Indian people, it touched like everybody. All the races, everybody, when they saw Word in Action, they wanted to know who was the pastor, who is this people, first time they're seeing this kind of dance, you know, they're accustomed to the usual church, you know, English songs, but first time they're seeing a hint of an Indian, you know, coming from India, coming to dance and sing and worship, and it was really good.